Hi there, in this video I want to show you the best free word cloud generator and to make word clouds like this. Those are a few examples, and I'll just show you some advanced examples here. Some more here. So I'll show you what I've done in the past. I've made them and put them inside a frame, like here in a laptop, or here in a photo studio, or here in this picture with a suitcase. And also I've added backgrounds to make the word cloud stand out more, like this one or this one. And the best software I found, I actually tried a lot of them and I downloaded some offline tools, and this was by far the best one. It used to be called Taggle and now it's called wordart.com. Let's go in then. You do have to just sign up, but you can download them for free. Let's go back to the main page so I can show you. So you get this as a main page and you just click create now. And let's create a new one. What I'm going to do is something like this one. We just make a simple one like this. So first of all, I need some words to go in there. I'm going to delete these, so I'm going to clear those. So we start with nothing. A tool I use to get the words is microstockgroup.com tools, and I'll leave a link to this below. But what you're doing is finding keywords. So you can put one word like love inside there, and you can choose how many images, but 10 is plenty. I'm going to click submit, select all those images, and submit again. And it'll just give us a list of words that people used as keywords in those images. So we can just click the ones we want. Just goes through some that will look good on here. Got 13, maybe 20 is enough. Okay, 20 is enough. And I'm just going to click there. It will select them all. Control C to copy. Go back to WordArt and click here, import words, and I'll put them in here. You can also just use a web page and it will grab the words from a web page, but I'm going to add these as text and then click import. You can also here remove words like and the and things like that, and you can remove numbers if you like. So I've imported those. Let's just click on visualize and see what it looks like. And so already we can see we've used the words there and they're all mixed up, some bigger, some smaller. Let's do some customizing then, just to make it look nice. Let's add a shape. So we've got this heart here. I think that's fine. There's a few more. I think this one's good enough. I've clicked on that. Let's visualize again. Okay, so we've got a heart shape there. Let's go to the next thing, the fonts. You can choose a font here, or what I quite often like to do, if I hold down the control key, I can just select many fonts and it looks a bit more random. So I'm going to do that. And let's visualize again. So it just looks a bit nicer, a bit more random. Looks okay. Let's go to the next one, layout. You can do a few different things here. You can make them, I'll just show you. So this one makes them horizontal and vertical. So they look like that. You can do random here. You can even do custom where you put the angle. So I'll come out of that. But you can do it custom if you've got a certain design you want. but we'll just look at random. I think let's try that. I think that looks fine. That looks good. We can also, if we change here, maximize or use the size from the columns. So if we want, we can actually say what size. We can make this word this happy, or maybe this love. We want bigger. We can make this 10 or something, and then this will make this word a lot bigger than the others. Let's visualize that. So that word love there is a lot bigger than the others. So that's just how you can use these numbers here. You can even, here you can change the color of a particular word, or the angle of a particular word, or even the font of a particular word. And if you only want that word love to appear once, then you can uncheck this column here. But we won't go into that much detail on this one. And I'm just going to put this back to maybe 2, so it's not so big. Let's just visualize and have another look. Yeah, so that's the sort of result I want. So we got down to, we did layout. We can also choose how many words we've got here. So if we think there's too many words, then we can have less words. Let's just visualize again. Or we can have more words. And we can even have it so we have lots of words, and then as we come down, it will remove the small ones there. So that can look good as well. By removing words like that, it doesn't look so crowded. It leaves a bit of space between them. If we come down even more, you can just leave a few words if you like it like that. That's just an option. Let's go down to colors. What it'll do by default is use the colors of the shape. So this shape was red, and by default that will make it red. But if we uncheck that, then it will use these colors here. At the moment, these are random colors. You can add more random colors like this. So we've got lots of random colors, and you can delete any colors you don't want. So we don't want any greens, we can do that. So that's one option. Let's delete all of these. And we can also go and just use the colors that we want. So if we use this drop down there, I can just choose reds and pinks. So I can choose that red, a dark red, maybe a very light pink. Could also change this and make it more mauve. So I can add that, maybe add a darker one of those, add an even darker one. So we can just, maybe I don't like this color, it's a bit too dark, let's delete that one. And let's add a few more, maybe a lighter pink, and maybe a slightly different red. Let's delete that one, I think it looks a bit darker than the rest. So we can just use the colors that we want here, either add them or delete them. You've got a thing here to change the darkness of the background. So we can make that white if we like. You can change the background color. We can make that black if we want. And just have the text there. What you'll want to do is if you're using the dark background, you'll want to have these as very light colors. And if you use a light background, you'll want to have these as dark colors. This rollover, this is if we're using it as a animated GIF, but we're not doing that at the moment. We're just making an image. So we don't need those. And we don't need this animation, we're not interested. So that's it, that's done. And just one more thing here, you can have it transparent. And if you do it transparent, then you can add your own background. But we won't do that in this case. So I think that looks good. I'm gonna click download and share. And for free, you get this standard quality PNG. If you want the other ones, then you do have to pay. if we try clicking on this one, we'll get a message and it will say to purchase a plan. So we're just going to download the free one, and this is plenty big enough. I think it's about 600 pixels or something, so it's plenty big enough to use for your website or anything like that, or social media. Let's click on it and just have a look. So that's the final one. That's pretty big and looks good quality. So that is wordart.com. And if you've got any questions, please leave them in the box below this YouTube video. I'll make a text version of this with some screenshots and I'll put it on my blog. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up so that other people will find it. And if you want other videos about using images and videos on your website and marketing, then please subscribe to my channel. Thanks a lot for watching the video, and I'll see you next time.